Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to ThinkView. I'm Casper. So I saw quite a few people paying thousands of dollars for an iPad and just using it like a Netflix machine. And many of them are my friends and acquaintances. So in today's videos, I'm gonna show you how do I get the most out of my iPad. And hint, there are 10 more ways to do so. One other thing that I frequently use an iPad for is as a second display using Sidecar. All you need is an iPad, a MacBook, and an iCloud account. Then go to your control center, choosing screen mirroring, and click on your iPad. And voila, now you have yourself a second monitor. The thing is, its latency is remarkable, as if it was hooked to my MacBook with some cable. And as I move my cursor, you can see that it's very responsive, isn't it? That's the great thing about the ecosystem, because on Windows laptop and Android tablet also have the same features. But it's not as responsive and seamless as this on an iPad. There, the problem with iPad for working professional is that they probably already have a MacBook, so there might be no need for an extra iPad. However, even for those people, you can still fully take advantage of the Sidecar feature to extend your screen space for your MacBook. The latency is very, very low and the image is crispy, and it feels just like having an extra monitor. The second use case where you can take full advantage of a cool set of features on iPad, even when you already have a MacBook, is when you are presenting. For example, in ThinkView Studio, we usually connect to an iMac through AirPlay, and a slide display on the iPad will immediately be mirrored. Then the interface on iPad will be optimized for presenter, while the interface on the TV will only show the slide to the audience. And at the same time on iPad, you can also take note on what you are speaking about for better visualization. And similar to the Sidecar, the AirPlay connection here is also extremely stable with very low latency. The third scenario, and probably the biggest reason why many students choose an iPad, is for taking note. I have been a fan of this for quite a long time, and don't you agree, using just an iPad is much more convenient than carrying a bunch of notebook and pen, right? And you can save documents and study material from your teacher more easily, or taking notes directly on them using the Apple Pencil. And of course, GoodNotes work great for this. And since iPad 18, the default Apple Notes application also has a lot of new features. For example, the iPad 18 now recognizes your handwriting, and every time you write, the app automatically corrects your text to match your writing style. Or when you copy some text from another document and paste in it, it also changes to match your handwriting. Convenient, right? I used to use GoodNotes a lot, but after the iPad 17 and 18 update, I switched back to Apple Note because it's now upgraded with so many new features for studying, like recording, automatic calculation, and better document management to organize information cleanly. For example, you can use this icon to link files together or manage lists to collapse or expand section. There are a lot of new features. But just a quick note, you should go with the 11-inch version at least, or if you can afford it, the 13-inch version will bring the best experiences. Studying with an iPad can turn you into a lifelong learner because all of your documents are stored in iCloud, so they're never lost. As long as you know where you store your file, you can access them anywhere, anytime, and on any Apple devices. But I think that's enough about studying and working. Let's talk about entertainment, and especially gaming. I have to say that iPad is a fantastic device for gaming. With its large screen, all you need is to connect to a controller and then you can play as many games as you want on Apple Arcade. You can even cast it to a TV to play with your family. Pretty awesome, right? In the future, Apple is also planning to bring more AAA games to the iPad. Like I'm playing the Assassin's Creed Mirage. It's awesome to play such kind of heavy game on an iPad. But even if you don't play AAA title, for now, the Apple Arcade library offers a good amount of family entertainment. Another key feature for an iPad is for drawing, even for professional users, and many digital artists already making a living with their iPad. Just a note is that if you need it for a professional drawing, you should go for the model with 120Hz refresh rate as it might reduce latency between the pen and the actual stroke appear on the screen. The sixth way that you can use the iPad is for work. Similar to the MacBook, and for those who need multitasking but don't require special software that is exclusive to a full-size PC or a MacBook, the iPad is now capable of handling that effortlessly. I believe that Apple could have turned the iPad into a MacBook 2.0, but they didn't, because it would have hurt their own business. Apple wanted to focus on serving the user with the need of learning and entertainment first. And once the need were met, and the Apple become well known, they began developing it for work-related tasks. And with the iPad convenient feature like being much lighter than a MacBook, and excellent touch support, I think that in the future we will be a new generation of user that fully adopt iPad for work, because they are now so used to touch devices. And in that scenario, the iPad might directly compete with all Ultrabook currently on the market. But that's still likely at 5 to 10 years from now. Okay, so the 7th method to use it is by connecting to an external display to expand your workspace. The Stage Manager feature on iPad is now fully developed, allowing you to freely resize windows at any angle you want, making multi-window multitasking on an external screen much more convenient. The 8th use is something my colleague have been doing recently, using the iPad to bring idea to life through freeform app. For example, in the evening, when he have online classes, he used the iPad to represent what he explaining, and as a bonus, he also used the desk view feature on his iPhone as a replacement for a MacBook webcam, giving him an additional overhead view of his desk like this. Okay, the 9th use is for watching movies. And it will be a waste not to mention this, as for many people, this is their Netflix machines. The 10th use is reading book. You might have forgotten that we have the iPad Mini 6, which is super compact, and you can use it to read book and even taking note directly on the pages that you're reading. Pretty neat, right? And that's it. These are 10 ways that I'm getting the most out of my iPad. And most importantly, these are all unique experiences that better on an iPad rather than a MacBook. But how about you? What do you use your iPad for most of the time? Let me know in the comment section, okay? I'm Casper from ThinkView. Thanks for watching, and see you guys next time.